Hey everyone, Dan UpLateGamer here, back for my second episode of my Houston Texans franchise. And if you saw the first episode, didn't go quite like I wanted it to. Ended up losing to Kansas City 34-3. As I said before, haven't played Madden in a while, but I've been practicing, so we're going to see how this goes this week. We're going to be taking on the Panthers, who's basically, to me, the best team in the NFL right now. So we're definitely going to have to see how this is going to go. But first thing I would like to do is, well, there's good and bad. We lost 34-3, but as you can see, the entire AFC South lost. So we're in first place. So that's good news. So I'm going to take a look at my team. I did add Addison from the Panthers. Traded a fifth-round pick for him. So he was. That's a big improvement to our left end on our defense. We did have 66 overall left end, and now we have Addison, who's a 78. So that's a big improvement to our defense. But we're going to get into this, get things going. First, I'm going to have to advance. Whoa, I'm sorry. Player season game. I'm sorry. But we're going to get into this and take on the Panthers. Definitely, I'm going to kick if I get it. So, here we go. Definitely want to get off to a good start this week. A lot better start than I did last week. Hopefully. I'm really enjoying Madden. I mean, it's a lot more fun. Even the Ultimate Team is a lot more fun than what I thought it was going to be. The thing they do give you a wide variety of cards to collect.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry.
So here we go.
This is the NFL on EA Sports. Two wide receivers will be looking to be number one targets on the field in today's game. It's Benjamin's Panthers going up against Hopkins' Texans.
Definitely going to have to be on the top of my game of what game I do have.
Texans, Panthers coming up on EA Sports. Week 2, football on tap as we get set for today's game.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Sims. And Phil,
can't really decide if I want to win. Looks like I'm kicking. Okay, so that's answered.
It's always a factor, Jim, when you have good weather. Now you can call anything you want and not worry about the elements disturbing your game plan. It's a complicated game. There's no doubt about it, but it's less complicated when you have good weather.
No turnovers this week.
The Panthers are back deep, waiting to return the kick. Nick Novak ready to kick it away to start today's game.
Decent kickoff.
And with that kick, we're underway. Brown's going to start his return. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down.
See what they're going to come out with right off the bat.
Today, having thrown an interception last week, he'll attempt to have a turnover-free game today.
I think the thing that catches you by surprise,
receiver, that's definitely I'm going to go in.
You go, my gosh, he's a big man.
3-4.
He's 6'6". He can run and has a very powerful throwing arm.
The Panthers are at the line of scrimmage and loading up that line with an extra tight end. First down at the 27.
Yes. Stopped him right in the backfield. Big play.
The Panthers offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Second down coming up.
Yeah.
Newton's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
Get on him. Hit him. Ah, he slid. I wanted to hit him. Third down and six.
The Panthers now facing third down. A week ago, they were up to the challenge in these spots. From the gun, Newton.
Oh, come on.
Well, these tight ends of the NFL now, they make the catches down the field. They're fast. They can do it all. And everybody is looking for that all-in-one, a guy that can block at the line of scrimmage, who can catch the football well, and has the speed to make it happen once he catches it.
Newton's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. To the ground.
Oh, that ain't good.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
I think when I was playing, anytime we crossed the 50-yard line, it was kind of like a big sigh of relief, because I knew now that there were a lot of things that could take place. I could afford to take sacks. I could afford to be a little more aggressive. Let's see how the offense reacts to this.
First down at the 44. Makes the grab.
Oh, come on.
There is nothing like having a great tight end in your offense now. There's so many things you can do with them. Remember, they're in the middle of the field. They can go down the middle. They can go outside. They can go short. They can go across. They can go out. Tough to cover the tight ends in this league now.
Stewart lined up as the single back. First down at the 27. Duke, handoff.
Definitely want to hold him to a field goal here.
And with that, let's take a look at the Panthers' offense. Last week, they posted big numbers on the ground, eclipsing the 200-yard mark. Play number six coming up on this drive. The Panthers snap it at the 26.
Yes, big play by Cushing there.
Down at the 26. Here's how the Texans defense, they have to put some pressure on the quarterback this week, as last week they did not have a single sack. Third down following the run. The Panthers have to get to the 17-yard line for a first down. Midway through the first. Looking at every option.
Got him. Yes.
Unmerciful to the quarterback.
Okay, held him to a field goal. That's huge for me.
Well, the defense has got to be excited any time on third down they make the play.
Should have sacked him way sooner.
But when you sack a quarterback on third down, that is one happy and emotional defense right now.
Yeah, he puts it through. It's all right. We held him to a field goal. I'll take that.
They put up three here in the first to take the lead.
It's always good to get those points on the board and get the lead and get the other team chasing you.
The Texans ready to take that football down the field.
I'm not going to be doing anything with that.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. Hoyer's taking the field now. This is his sixth season as a quarterback in the NFL.
Yes, Hoyer is back. He was injured all through the preseason. Looking for big things from him, hopefully.
Foster's lined up directly behind the quarterback here.
Go, go, go!
lined up in the backfield. First down at the 20. Nate Washington with the grab.
I'm actually learning my audibles a little bit better.
Good job by the quarterback completing that pass.
Second down and one. Lock that. If I could do that every time. I don't want that. I put it at draw accidentally. That's a mistake. Gonna switch that up. Go with the halfback dive.
Second and short. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster.
Foster's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
The Texans take it from the 33.
That was almost interception.
Going in the other direction. Here's the offensive line, which must protect its quarterback today. It's now second down.
Oh, I should have kept him going straight. That's my man.
On the offensive side, it's third long. There's very few.
Thanks, Grayson. Yes, I got blue in there. I'm actually thinking about trading Foster because he's just going to get slower. Third down and 11. Get in there. I don't think I got it. Fourth and inches. Where am I at?
They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down coming up.
Oh, this is crazy.
The Texans will punt.
Yeah, I've got a punt. Didn't want to. Yes, big hit.
After a gain of three and a run back.
I wanted to go for it, Grayson, but I was on my side of the 50. They stuffed me. I could be in big trouble.
Control of the football. They did not come away empty-handed, but did not get a touchdown either.
Well, they got that field goal, and I think that's important. That field goal gave them a little confidence. They got some points up there that always makes you feel good on the offensive side. Now take advantage of that good feeling. Go out there and score a touchdown this time.
Let's see if they can finish off a drive. First down at the 20. Stewart's going to secure the handoff. Stewart's tackle right at the 28. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Nothing like a running back who fights for every extra yard. When you get that extra yard or two, what it does, it just creates better situations for your offense.
The Texans' defense now is going to go nickel. Second down, two to go. Slashes to the left side.
I think he got it, though.
Just a few yards.
First and 10, yeah. So at the end of the first quarter, down 3-0.
Quarter of play. We're seeing two defenses controlling the play. We'll be back in a moment. Back here in the second quarter, defense ruled the first. And what are we going to see here, you think, in the second quarter, Phil?
Well, I think the first thing they got to do, Jim, is just believe in what they did all week long and preparing for the game. All the practices, all the film sessions, and just know sometimes it takes more than one quarter to get the answer. So stay with the game plan and see if you can find a way to make it work.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short game.
Second down after going to the ground game the first play.
Definitely want to keep somebody on.
He'll get it again.
Oh, we should have had him in the backfield. Thanks, Gigafeed. Thanks for joining the stream. Hopefully I can play a better game than last week.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Yes, big sack.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback. And the best person to do it is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
Loss of five on the play. Second down coming up.
Wait a minute.
Quarters formation here for the defense.
Got him again. Oh, I thought I had a sack. They are. The Panthers are super good.
Third down following the incompletion. They'll go shotgun here.
Yes, another big sack. Definitely playing better this week.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
Hopefully I can get a good return here.
Short's going to take this one from the 28.
Oh, if I could have stayed up, I should have went.
At the 34, and a run back of about six. The Texans offense coming out now, hoping to get something put together. But this has become a defensive battle so far, Phil, and a busy day for the punters.
Yeah, and it gets frustrating sometimes when you're playing these type of battles as a quarterback or as an offense. So you got to be careful, respect what the defense is doing.
Boy, I don't know. We'll have to just wait and see.
The Texans have it at the 34. Foster is taking the handoff. And at the 37, he'll be brought down. To the 2 yard carry, it sets up second down and eight. The Panthers lined up in the nickel. Three step drop. DeAndre Hopkins with the grab. They bring him.
Boy, if you saw me play my first episode, this is so much better.
Great confidence in the receiver, and why not? He's talented, and every time the football is thrown his way, he finds a way to make the catch.
Coming to the line right at the 50.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Hoyer's going back to the air on this play. Catch made.
All right. 4 minutes, 12 seconds left.
Probably the easiest throw for a quarterback to make in the NFL is the curl route, because you can see the receiver, his body is square to you, drill it in there. Nice job.
The football is at the 38. First down at the 38. And straight ahead, Foster.
When you run the football like this, if you show toughness, there is no doubt. When you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Sorry, I'm not. If I'm not talking enough, it's just I'm really trying to concentrate and get this done right.
The Texans from the 32, and the quarterback.
Get in there. I think I got it. Third down and one.
But there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short game.
Now third and short, following the run. The quarterback with the give to the fullback. Brought down at the 20. First down on the way. We're getting close to the 2-minute warning. Time for one more play.
2-minute warning. All right. Going to run a gun split Texan mash. I'm going to smart route my square receiver. I think it'll be Hopkins.
And now as we come back to the field, we're looking at a defense trying to maintain a lead going into the break. The Texans are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Hoyer's going to take it from the gun.
Oh, I almost blew that. I was supposed to just loop that over the top.
That's a nice play that time by the defense. The offense is inside the red zone. You've got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job of swatting the football away.
Breaking huddle at the 20.
Here we go. 45.
Second and 10. He'll go Brown. A gain of 8. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Well, when you have a successful draw play, a lot of times it's up to the quarterback. As he's dropping back, if he holds that football up and makes everybody think it's a pass, it works. And then when he hands it to the running back, look out.
Going with halfback blast.
Brian Hoyer will take it from the center. Back to the ground.
I'm just going to try to keep it on the ground here and get it in the end zone.
First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
Got to pay attention to the clock here. I got to get this going.
First and goal from the 6.
Oh, man. Messed that up.
Texans signal for a timeout. They have 2 remaining. This long drive continues. Second and goal from the 4.
Yes, touchdown.
Finding the end zone for the first time this season.
Boy, I don't know about Kirk Cousins. Well, I can't believe I got a lead on the Panthers. If y'all saw my first episode, you will be amazed. I mean, I was horrible, but I've been studying. And I mean, I've been studying a lot.
You just feel like all the hard work you put in the week, you put it to good use, and you want to keep that lead going into halftime.
The Texans for the extra point. It's good.
I don't think he'll sit him. I really don't. I don't think Kirk Cousins will be sitting out.
They're suddenly trailing. The score's 7-3. Nick Novak ready for the kickoff.
Now I just got to keep things together. Thanks to everyone who has joined the stream. I'm really enjoying Madden. I'll be back to some MLB The Show very soon, maybe tonight after this. I haven't decided. Sacks were big in the first half. How many wide receivers? I got...
The Panthers come to the line in a tight game here in the second quarter. The score's 7-3. First down at the 20.
Oh. I got to get somebody on him. I can't remember. I haven't been able to find how to put somebody right on the cover back, quarterback.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. The Texans with a nickel look here on defense. First down at the 34. The grab is made by Kelvin Benjamin. The Panthers decide to take a timeout here, leaving them with only one. That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go. Second down, even after the completion. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. Olsen's
oh, come on, get on him.
And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most of all, conserve that timeout. Those are big down the
street. Definitely want to keep them out of field goal range.
Territory at the 49. Newton in shotgun formation.
Yes, get on him.
The quarterback. The Panthers have to take their final timeout. That's it. Third down now. Newton's got it in the gun.
Oh, yes. I was fixing to say if they let him catch that.
We're late in the second, and that stop is huge, almost guaranteeing this team to have the lead when they go to the locker room.
Yeah, everything is on their
and
side.
I'm getting the ball
now,
first in the second half. So that's going
to
be huge also.
To be smart, don't make a big mistake to give the other team any momentum.
Oh, he shanked it. He shanked it.
Will not be returned. It will never see the field of play as it sails out of bounds. The Panthers couldn't stop the pass. They couldn't stop the run the last time they were on the field.
Oh, my gosh. And the coaches are furious at the way they played. I thought the defensive calls were good. The techniques and the execution was awful.
If I can get in field goal range...
Plenty of defensive backs.
Somehow.
For this one. Boyer standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Hopkins can't.
It ain't going to happen. I only got 7 seconds. I don't need to chance anything.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented
receiver, I need to just.
Got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, he can make a big play.
Going to run in here, take this into the half with a lead.
The Panthers' defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Texans from the 27. Oscar tackled down. We're headed to the half here in a tight.
So, all right, we're going to get the ball back first. Our running game's going really well, so I'm really going to try to stick to that.
Coming up next.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Both the Panthers and the Texans are in a defensive battle right now. The scoring is at a minimum, so both teams have to feel like if they can...
Hey, how you doing, Angry Mark?
...that they'll come away with
the
win.
If you, didn't, you were here for the first episode, I think, before my first game. I think you were. I can't remember. You've been on almost every one of my streams. You've come in at least to say hi, and I really appreciate it. If you saw the first... My first game of the year, you'll see how much better I'm doing. A lot better than last time. Hopefully, I can just keep it up. Oh, I should have done much better on that.
Panthers defense had a rough go of it in the first half, Phil. And let's see what they can do now to start the second half.
Well, they got manhandled. They got beat up. They got pushed around. I mean, let's toughen up and change things around.
They send the tight end in motion. Second half gets rolling now as he.
Ain't gonna go nowhere.
He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Boston's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second.
We're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new
He stepped in front of him. Barely thought I was going to get that one away, but it didn't. Okay, so you, Angry, you did say how horrible it was, though. So this game's going much better. Hey, Randy, how you doing?
Take a quick break.
Uh-oh, Brown's hurt.
Cam Newton takes a look now from under center. The Panthers snap it at the 31. Handoff out of the I formation.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Just a quick drop back. Looking across the
middle, he's wide open.
Olsen has the catch. That's his fourth catch of the day.
Panthers just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
Here's the first snap after the big play. The give. Stewart's brought down after picking up only a yard.
Nice job.
Thanks, Grayson. I appreciate it. I mean, I don't have the greatest voice, I know. I'm from the South. But I do my best. And I appreciate it.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
He's going to run it. Get in on him. Oh, come on. That was my fault. Dang it. Hit the wrong button and the guy died. Terrible play. I had him and I screwed it up.
In a situation like this, I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
The Panthers will take the snap from the 35. Olsen's got it.
Get on him.
And as we get a better look at the numbers, here's a tight end who has done his best to make a huge impact the last couple of weeks, Phil.
Yeah, he's always determined, isn't he, Jim? You watch him play, he plays so hard. And when you do these type of things, the football just finds its way towards you. Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players.
Oh, get on him. Jeez.
They need to make a big play here.
He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
The Panthers know once they get inside the 20-yard line, you have to be able to run the football also. It can't be pass, pass, pass. all the time. The offensive line comes through. Good solid run that time.
Get on him. Get him. Man, somebody nail him.
We don't always get to see defensive
definitely got to hold
them.
Got to hold them.
It's been exactly that low-scoring game, and it's because both defenses have really stepped up and done their job.
Yeah, a lot of people look at games
coming
like
with three
right
wide receivers.
It's fun to see because we don't get to see it too often, and what it does, it puts a lot of pressure on the players and especially the coaches to make decisions that are going to give their team a chance to win in a game like this.
The Texans defense now is going to go nickel. From the gun, Newton.
Oh, come on.
Newton's now got 5 touchdown passes on the season.
I like the South Angry Mark.
And that touchdown puts them in a very good position. Holding the lead with this game getting ready to enter its final stages.
Yeah, you know what? You put the pressure on the defense. Let's go out there and do their job. Don't
okay, I got plenty of time.
Call aggressive plays, and you got to tell your defensive players, run and gang tackle the person with the football.
Newton's going to look on now from the sidelines. That last drive, he contributed more than 50 yards in the air. Catches it at the 9 and starts his return. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. The Texans weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim. And you do that by showing different formations of plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
The Texans will take the snap from the 30. And straight ahead, Foster. He struggled.
They get three, maybe.
Last week, and that continues today.
We all need help, don't we? We need help. And this running back, that's what he needs. They need to run some different plays, give him a chance to get some success.
Why can I not pick a there we go.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Quarterback gives it to Arian Foster. That's stopped by Roman Harper.
Foster's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Brian Hoyer takes it from the center. Third down and 4.
Oh, come on. He couldn't get rid of it.
Fireworks.
Defense has been the name of the game out here. So
gonna have to hold them this time.
Both of them doing a good job.
Or get a big hit here.
Winning the battle against the offense.
Game 16.
Brown, such a great athlete. You gotta find ways to get the football to him. Here's another way to get it to him. On a punt return, how explosive is he? Man, Barry, that's the answer.
Well, the fourth quarter is fast approaching. Partner, as this defense takes the field, they've got to know that a stop here is crucial.
Yeah, it is. And look, you can't worry about the score on the defensive side right now. Go out there and do your job. And don't worry about the fact that your offense is stinking up.
They're definitely going to be running the ball.
About 4 yards a carry.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
2 tight ends on the field here. Second down, 4 to go. Breaks at the
get on him. Yes.
All over the ball carrier.
I say get on him a lot.
My gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop a runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
the way.
Going to have a big play. Need a big play here.
To the 38 for a first. Newton's back in shotgun formation. Jonathan Stewart.
Get on him. Yes.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Got a chance, so. Got a chance.
Quarter started here, partner. And this defensive battle has the feel of a game potentially headed to overtime.
Oh, absolutely. This game is so tight and the scoring is so hard to come by that I would not be shocked at all to see it go into overtime. But, hey, still a ways to go. Can both of these teams continue to play this way and not make that big mistake?
The Texans' defense has been terrific. These coordinators on defense on both sides have to be thrilled because they have ruled this game.
Oh, boy, defenses, man, when they rule games, you know, they love it. They talk the talk, you know, they're tell you over on the sideline yelling at the offense, come on and do something because we're doing such a great job. But I like these defensive struggles, Jim.
Go, go, go! Hey, hey. Left, left, left.
The Texans line up, split backfield. First down at the 20. And it's batted down.
That was a bad play.
That was an incomplete pass that time against cover two. Safeties, and you really want to throw the football down the middle or deep down the sidelines. That time the quarterback didn't do that, and that's why it was incomplete.
Second down and 10.
What?
Well, I know this feeling. When a blitz was coming,
third down at 21.
As a quarterback, but try to protect yourself because you're going down.
The sack.
Gonna need a big play here. I mean, a huge play.
Set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. Hoyer's gonna take the snap from the shotgun. Incomplete, and this is going to be a three and out. It's almost
gonna have to hold him again.
Ways to unlock this defense. Now into the fourth quarter.
You would think so, Jim. When you watch what they're doing on the offensive side, they have no answers. But when you can't block them, it's hard to have success on the offensive side.
Brown's got it on the fair.
They're going to have good field position.
Close game right now, partner. And you look at the matchup at running back, and neither one of them has really been all that effective.
No, Jim, they have not been. I'll say this to the running backs, to the coaches, to the offensive line, everybody. Stay patient, stay with the run game, and I think it will work.
The Panthers in quite a battle here in the fourth. The score's 10-7. First down at the 48. And here's the throw. Cam Newton throws it.
Oh, what? Whatever. That isn't good.
In the fourth, and they look to have seized control of this one with that
him a guy right there.
They did. Now it's up to the defense. Go out there and shut the opponent's offense.
I have to score now.
This game's in the bag.
Need a big return.
Ready to receive the kick.
I guess you like the Raiders. Drake.
Short's gonna drop to a knee here, so this will come out to the 20. The Texans. Phil, what's the issue with this team? This offense specifically. Three straight drives without a score.
Well, Jim, I'd say this. It's bad coaching. I just hate what they're trying to do on the
bad coaching.
Side. Not putting their players in position to give them a chance to compete against this defense. They've got to change things up, give their offense a chance, and give these players a chance.
Arian Foster lined up in the backfield. He'll throw.
Look at this. What should I expect?
Keekly's able to show off those great hands and picking off that pass from the linebacker position. What a job and what a pair of hands.
The Panthers offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Love what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up and they
going to be really tough to keep them out of field goal position.
Try to duplicate what they just did. If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Second and nine coming
I need
up.
A turnover big time.
The Panthers will take the snap from the 30. Olson's got it.
What the heck? This is getting out of hand now. They're just so good. I mean, they are just so good.
What a great passing offense. You need a tight end who can really force the defense to cover him underneath, and especially deep down the field. This tight end can do it all.
First down following the long play. Gets the handle here.
What a job by the defense down on the goal line. They were playing run all the way. It was a run. They got the penetration, and they tackled the runner for a loss.
Loss of four on the play. Here they come to the line of scrimmage at the 12. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. Ted Ginn has the catch. And that's a gain of maybe five.
Right now, I just want to hold him to a field goal.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Newton's now completed his last seven passes. The Texans lined up.
Definitely got to watch for the quarterback.
Third and goal from the seven.
Look at this. How was he wide open?
That's his first touchdown catch of the season. And with so little time left in this game, that touchdown may have sealed the deal.
It's it. The party is officially over. And what a job. The offense just put an exclamation point on that game. They've been terrific all day long, and they deserve the win.
The Texans are getting ready for the return. And can they return to a competitive state in this one as the game is starting to get out of hand? The score is 24-7. The Panthers defense has to still be inspired about that interception they had last time out.
Absolutely. They had everything going for them, I think, in that play. They had pressure. Everybody was hustling to the football, and a good play on that errant throw by the quarterback.
First down at the 20. Looking long. Intercepted. The Panthers have built a team around this quarterback.
All right.
And these type of numbers are more like what we expect from him. Newton's bounced back from a tough start, and now he is looking great.
Yeah, he is looking good, and you are right. They built this offense around him. We know that because of his talent, and don't like to talk about it sometimes, but he's paid an awful lot of money to get it done, and he's getting it done right now down on the field. This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
The Panthers have it at the 44, running right through the trenches.
They're definitely going to run the ball.
The defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
After that last carry, it's third and three. Jonathan Stewart with the
football. Oh, I had him.
Gains 17. He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground.
Good job by the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down. And that's what you want to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can, and keep picking up those first downs.
Again, the lead on him. Moore's there to take it down.
When you're going against a really athletic defense, there's nothing like reverses and the counter run game, because they see it, they go, and you counter it, and that's why it works to perfection.
Welcome back. Coming out of the two-minute warning here in the final quarter. An extra tight end on the field for this one. The Panthers will take the snap from the 30. We'll run it with him again. Game's 11.
Man, I don't even think I need to say anything. It's just going south.
Back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there, picks up a first down. That's nice.
First down at the 19. Handoff. Picked up a couple that time.
Yeah, I love situations like this. This is when I was at my best, getting in the huddle and telling everybody all the things. Put two hands on the football. Don't anybody jump off sides. Don't take any chances. And most of all, stay in bounds.
The Texans with a nickel look here on defense. Second down and 8. Right back to him once more.
And he gets the first down. They're just going to run the clock out.
By the offense, they pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
Well, Phil, a two-game losing streak for these guys. It's a tough little stretch they're going through.
Yeah, it is. And you know what? You got to.
Well, I lost, but it was better, a better game, at least in the first half than it was my first episode. Things are only going to get better. I'm just going to try to build the team, make it a better team, get myself better, get the team better, and hopefully by the end of the season, this will be a good Texans team. But thanks for checking out my episode of my Houston Texans franchise. It was a lot of fun the first half. Second half, wasn't not so much. But thanks, everyone, for watching, and I'll see you next time.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long.